Hey, what's up, guys? It's Rare here. And, yeah, today we're finally doing the Unretiring continues, but I am not on stream. It is another support game. We're going to be playing some Alistar in the bot lane. And we are going to be joined by AJ, aka Flixpoint. He's going to be playing Zed in mid, and it's going to be a good time, man. So, lots of people talking about lots of things, it seems. That's whatever. So, let's do a quick analysis of our teams. We're going to be doing... Guys, we're doing an analysis. Guys, it's been months. We're doing an analysis. Okay. All right. So, top lane, we got Renekton versus... Actually, no, Jax is jungle. I'm sorry. Top lane is Vi. That threw me off there. Mid lane, Orianna Zed matchup. And then we have Xin Zhao, Jax in jungle. Nami against myself as support. And then Jinx and Jhin. So, not going to troll this guy and headbutt his Gromp away because that's rude. Getting a couple more shots in there. But yeah, should be a good time. So, bit of poke and sustain in bot lane versus potentially a large amount of actual all-in from Jhin and I. Being Alistar. Some decent combo potential there. Let's get readjusted in our seat. Gonna get prepped and ready here. Given that Nami a bunch of free gold. Jhin's creepy, man. But hey, he's on my side, so whatever. It's all good. We haven't gotten a skill yet, because we're just going to see, you know, what becomes of the lane. Should I require a headbutt? I'll get a headbutt. And if not, I won't. Simple as that. So for now, we're just going to hang out. Jhin will get zapped away by the Jinx. But so far, we're doing just fine in regards to overall CS. So that's okay. They will hit level 2. Slightly before us. Nice juke on the bubble there from Jhin with his burst of movement speed from Whisper. Yeah, that's right. I went and read the skill abilities before I got in this game. I actually read them before period because I've been wanting to play Jhin to see how it is, but you get my point. We'll juke that zap while I'm looking at the audio levels on the video because that's multitasking, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, my bad. RIP. Messed up Jhin's combo, but it's cool. I get some free poke and nothing really comes of it, so it's fine. Now that's a little awkward in that his bouncing grenade just like basically didn't kill anything, so it didn't gain damage. My understanding is that when it kills something, whether it be a minion or champion or whatever, it continuously does more damage with the bounces, but he didn't actually kill anything, so that's a little awkward. It's all good though. So first blood will go to our Renekton. Okay, they trade. So, the first blood gold, obviously nice for their Vi, so a little unfortunate, but not a huge deal. So, just kind of a net neutral. No junglers in play either. It's all good. Oh, shit. Okay. Can I get over to AJ to help? Maybe. So, I'll make sure that he's good. I don't know why Jhin went and engaged when I was clearly making my way over to make sure that he got out, so that's a little bit unfortunate. Bit of a miscommunication. I guess I should have pinged like my intention there. I'm not sure if he like started following after me or something, but yeah, didn't want that to happen. Was not my intent to get my AD carry killed. Kappa. Hard to believe, I know. But we'll go ahead and pick up that cart gold. Might as well. We got the kill, Jinx. Yeah, it was not a solo kill, so Nami helped as well. Okay. Well, it is what it is. What do I want to level up? Probably headbutt. But if this is going to just be a sustained party, it'd actually be better for me just to level up heal a little bit. I don't know. I could see it either way. Well, after that nice little chain there, change my mind and we're going headbutt. If Jhin can do that again, we can make things happen here. So unfortunately, they do have a bit of poke, as I'd mentioned. So now I don't think I can WQ correctly, to be completely honest with you. I'm too rusty. I don't think we'll get it correctly done in quite some time. Don't want to stand on those chompers there. But we might try it later. Ooh, nice, I got it. So we will force an exhaust there. But at the same time, just overall, pretty good trade. Not perfect, but pretty good. We almost got the trap route there. That would have been really awesome. I think that would have probably led to a kill on Nami, but I don't think the trap was set and ready at the time. I believe that's what occurred. No, don't shoot that. I want it to come up here so I can get it for you, bro. Teamwork, bro Chacho. Alright, all good. Still got it there. I want her to come over to the wall again. That was a really easy WQ combo. Also, I do find it ironic how I've been saying, oh, I'm probably not going to get WQ correctly, and then immediately the next time I WQ, we get it perfectly fine. So, that was nice. Anyway, so some trades back and forth between top laners and junglers. Nothing too noticeable there. The Jhin trap will go off. Not too much of it, but again, that's alright. How are we doing on CS? Oh, we're actually up. There you go. All is well. It does seem like Jhin has some pretty good execution-based abilities, like just with his grenade, with the force shot on Whisper in regards to last hitting. So it seems like it's pretty easy to last hit on Jhin. Again, that could be a bit of a generalization. I haven't actually played him myself, but just strictly from what I've seen in game, it does seem rather doable. I also really like the burst of movement speed mechanic on the fourth shot of Whisper. Just think that's really interesting. So, overall, he's a cool champion, man. Nice kill by AJ in the mid lane. Good stuff there. And yeah, man, we're about 5-6 CS up. That's good. That's good. Oh. Well. Yeah, didn't really have anything to tell you there, bud. Because I couldn't see her. But that's understandable that AJ would be a little bit frustrated there. I'd be frustrated there, so. Sorry, man. Not trying to leave you out to dry. It was an accident. I assure you. Anyway, so it's another kill for Jinx, which kind of sucks. We don't really want Jinx to be getting too fed, if we can help it. But I've done two successful WQ combos, so hey, there's that. Now can I position myself to where I can make something happen? Oh, that's not good. Okay, well, I mean, we still got the ult, so it's not that bad either. That might force it back from them, it's looking like, so, or not. Alright, hopefully that got him into tower range. Whoa, okay. Well, here comes curtain call. Come on. Come on. Alright, that's one. That's two. I don't have enough mana, but I'm gonna try to help here. Alright, that should be it. That's three. That's some good action right there, man. So they should be able to get the tower with that wave of minions. I'm just gonna go back, but I mean, that was good. That was straight good right there. Now I'm just gonna go back. Well, okay. If they want a dragon, that's fine. We can do that. I probably wouldn't have opted to do it myself. I think it's a little greedy, but we got a Xin Zhao, got a Jhin. They both have pretty high damage. I can tank this if I need to, so I'm going to go ahead and opt to do that now. All right, and a headbutt smite will seal it. We'll head home. Good stuff. Nice solo kill in the top lane by Renekton there. So, alright, we turned things around quite well there. A nice 3-kill pickup. We did not get the tower, but it's not that big of a deal. Oh, we'll do something like this. I'm still kind of trying to learn just overall optimal builds in regards to season 6, this is like my, I don't know, 6th game of season 6, something like that. So, still not perfect, but you know what? That's okay. So let's see. So AJ itemized against Orianna. Makes plenty of sense given their lane components. We have Hunter's Talisman on Xin Zhao, and then looks like we're going to be seeing Purple Enchant out of Jax here. Vi going for maybe like Trinity Force? Not really sure yet. We'll see what happens. Right there. Well, that's annoying. But I greeted for the cart. I think I can heal myself. Granted, I don't even have any health bonuses, so it was pretty greedy of me. I kind of ceded a lot of lane control there for just one minion. In retrospect, not really worth it, but eh, we'll see. Maybe I can bait them into doing something really stupid now and can flash W someone. That's always fun. I keep on thinking that's Zap, and that's not Zap, that's Jhin. But that's alright. Alright, so we do a good job of getting Jhin CS there, so throw up a full ward just so we have vision in the brush. I could also try to get sight around the river, but just right now I'm not really worried about it. Oh, okay. Orianna's bot, so there's that. Okay. Damn, I should have flashed that. That could have actually been a kill if I had gone more aggressive. Yeah, no, I should have flashed W'd that. That could have actually been a kill if I had just been more aggressive. Because she had already taken 2 tower shots, which means it would have just done even more damage to Nami. And with the Q headbutt and Jhin giving it an auto from Whisper, that likely would have been a free kill for him. So a little bit of timidity on my part results in a lack of a kill. But next time, baby. Next time. See if we can't get her to come up further forward this time. Nice kill by AJ and co. Ooh, man. Jhin taking a little bit too much extra damage from that zap there. It does hurt. So, he's just respecting the like bubble potential and whatnot from Nami. I think he's being a little overly cautious, but at the same time, Jinx is just pushing it in anyway, so, you know, whatever. Come on. Oh, shit. Ah, slightly off. I miscalculated the distance there. Hashtag next time can't spell English. Oh, that was a huge fail. Well, I got ambitious. I'll be the first to admit it. I got ambitious. Simple as that. So, they're just going to keep on pushing FCS into us, which is honestly pretty fine. We'll just keep on farming. I might even roam. I don't have flash, but that doesn't mean I can't try to force something. So, we do see purple enchants coming out of both members here. Yeah, I mean, if they're gonna push, let's wait for Xin and then go. Alright, now we go. Ah, okay. Well, that must be warded then, but that's fine. I'm gonna position myself up here just in case if something hokey happens. Oh! Well, now that bush is really warded. Don't worry. If they pink it, it's 6 shots, not 3. He says as it just gets. Oh, hey, look! There you go. Value. There you go. The commentary holds true. 6 shots, boys, not 3. Sick LCS play. Totally read the situation from our opponents, knowing they're going to strip that brush. All mind games, guys. All mind games. Just like that fail flash into pulverized combo hitting nothing. That was a I am confident in my abilities play, and I know that I am the real man. I do not agree with this. He's totally dead. Well, I might be okay here. Okay, I'm okay here. Am I okay here? Juke the bubble. Shit! Fuck! Ah! Okay, alright. Oh, shit. Alright. I'm actually gonna stick around here, just because I know. Okay, I sacrificed myself there because I wanted Jin to get the gold. There's two reasons I went in there. One, and this was legitimate, I legitimately did this on purpose. I wanted to make it so that Jax wasn't able to focus on Zed. And then if Jax comes at me, his counter-strike's on cooldown, and I knew I had to get off at least a pulverize or a headbutt just to keep him, like, even temporarily locked up, and Jin picks up the kill. That was an intentional death on my part in order to try to bait out a situation that would be favorable for Jin. And it did work out that way, so I don't regret that play at all. Super risky, obviously. Like, if Jin's root didn't follow up on my position, or, you know, maybe I just die right off the bat before he has a chance to react. There's plenty of ways that could have gone really wrong, but I think it was the correct decision to make given the situation. So anyway, Dragon is back up. I don't know if Orianna has flash. She probably does. She has barrier as well. It's good to know. So, not sure where... never mind. Navi's just chilling in bot. For a second, I thought she was going to be coming around doing something, but it does not seem that is the case. Nothing can hold me back. Orianna doesn't seem like she's really gankable right now, so I'm just going to go help Jin. She's too far forward at the moment, and while Jin getting solo experience is all well and good, I do want to keep on leveling, and I do have 3 stacks of my passive here. So, nice kill by Zed. Looks like they're going to be okay. Eh, maybe not. We're probably going to get there too late to really do anything. I guess we could curtain call. Maybe. Nah. I think we'll just let it go. Ori was low. We could just force this. Nice kill up top. Reluctant's doing quite well, just given the situation. I did just walk on top of the ball. That was a little questionable there. Can we get this tower? Probably not. Actually, wait, if Orianna ults on cooldown, we probably could have. Oh well, whatever. At this point, honestly, it's fine. I think we are keeping 2 of them here to where they can't roam. I mean, man, there's nowhere really to roam on the map anyway, but... The idea... 3 mid. The idea being, they're not, like, bot lane getting farm. They're not top disrupting Renekton in any, like, really meaningful way, so... And honestly, they can push in this lane. It's perfectly fine. Got him. Nice. Slightly questionable headbutt on my part, but I mostly just wanted to make sure that he didn't get off a full combo on either Zed or Jin. We should be good at this tower, though. Or not. Awkward. Super awkward. Okay, that almost killed me. That would have been unfortunate. Like, I'd love to stay around and chat, boys, but I'm basically dead. Kappa. Actually, Xin Zhao is getting dragon while this is happening, so this is still good that we're just keeping them busy. Yeah, that's still totally worth it. This is a bit of a ballsy back on my part, but... Alright, we're good. That was totally worth it, just overall. I'm gonna go for cooldown boots. I think that's fine. Again, like I said, like, super optimal build. I don't really know what to be looking for. I'm just kind of rolling with it, honestly. But, yeah, man. I think this is fine. So, let's see. 0-1-4. Despite an amazing flash pulverize on dirt to show it who's boss, we've been doing okay this game. We did have that one intentional death to Jax that landed us... another net 2 kills, so I think that was totally worth it. Fuck you, Jax. suck my word. And, yeah, man, I'm feeling pretty good about this right now. Okay. AJ does not give any fucks. That just happened. Just gonna make sure this tower goes down here. Hashtag lane frozen, messing it up. But, meh. Meh. Come at me. Come at me. Alright. Oh, damn it. I tried to make that work, but Jinx Rocket spoils the fun. Oh, Jesus. Okay. Wow. I forgot the thing automatically crits on fourth shot. That thing fucking hurts, dude. If I can get in range of Jinx, we might actually be able to kill her. Like, I have ultimate. I will risk doing something incredibly stupid for the sake of glorious plays. Because that's just how we roll. Meanwhile, Xin Zhao once again making the right call doing a split while we are busy elsewhere. Good shit to see, good shit to see. I mean, Orio isn't even ult right now, so I don't even really have to care. Come at me, Jax! Nice. Completely and totally worth it. And that's why Alistar ult is awesome, because it just lets you do whatever the heck you want. You can make total YOLO plays and not get punished for it. Good stuff. Alright. I don't think we're really going to be taking this tower, to be honest. So, oh, well, okay, GG, there you go. Alright, 0-1-7 with one death being intentional. Good shit, man. We got to make a couple fun plays there. Got a couple nice little Alistar ult tricks up our sleeves, and we actually got WQ combos successfully off, and a decent commentary, I'd like to think. And thank you all for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video as always, and I'll see you next time. Peace out.